Hello student, welcome back. This is Vasant Naik from Vastech channel. In this session, we will see programming and interfacing the 8255. So now what is 8255? In the previous session, previous video, you must have seen the decoding of IO address, but it is found that they are not dynamic in nature. So we use 8255. 8255 is a programmable peripheral interface. That means this is a 40 pin DIP, dual inline dual inline package input output chip, which contains three ports A, B, C, which can be programmed as either input port or output port. That's why it is named as programmable peripheral interface, and it is dynamically it can be changed in contrast to 74LS244 and 373, which is hardwired, which you have seen. Next one is 8255. Normally in the exam they will ask the architecture of 8255. In your syllabus, in your book, the architecture of 8255 is not mentioned, so better if they ask about 8255, better to write this one, 8255. So here you can see there is a port A, port B, port C, 8 bit, all ports are 8 bit. Pin numbers are not essential, pin names are essential. So port A can be configured as either input port or output port. Port B can be configured as either input port or output port. Port C can be configured as either input port or output port. Port C is further split into two, upper port C and lower port C. Upper port C and lower port C, something like this. PC 0 to PC 3 is called as lower, this one is a lower port. And PC 4 to PC 7 is called as upper port C. So port C can be programmed individually. So other than that, so we have data bus D0 to D7, 8-bit data bus that is connected to the microprocessor. And other than that, we have read signal, write signal, AO, A0, A1, reset, chip select. Chip select signal is connected to decoder. So it is necessary to mention chip select signal is connected to decoder. Now here you can see, how the port is selected? Port is selected based on these three signals, A0, A1 and CS. So based on the combination, port A is selected, port B is selected, port C is selected, and if the combination is 1-1, control register is selected. What is the control register? Control register shows the configuration of the port A, port B, port C. That is, whether port A is in input mode or output mode, port B is input mode or output mode, port C is input mode or output mode. All this information is stored by this control register. So then what is the configuration of the control register? So the configuration of the control register, you can see here, it is 8-bit register, and it is configured into two groups. One is group B, other one is group A. Last bit is called as, if the last bit D7 is 1, then it is input output mode. Otherwise, bit set reset mode. If it is 0, bit set reset mode. In group B, we have port C configuration, port B configuration and mode selection. If this bit is 0 means mode 0, and if this bit is 1 means mode 1, that you will see later. Port B, if it is 1 means input port, 0 means output port. Port C, especially for a lower port, lower bits of the port C, that is PC0 to PC3, 1 means input, 0 means output. Here you can see group A, this bit, especially port C, upper bits of port C, PC4 to PC7, 1 means input and 0 means output. And this bit D4 is port A, 1 means input, 0 means output. And D4 and D5 and D6 is 00 means mode 0, 01 means mode 1, and 1x means mode 2. X means X is like either 0 or 1. So this is the configuration control register format. So in the exam, it is necessary to write control register format or mode selection. So now we have one ALP. So find the control word. If PA is equal to out, PB is in, PC0 to PC3 in, and PC4 to PC7 out. Program the 8255 to get the data from the port A and send it to port B. In addition, data from PCL low is sent out to PCU. Here is a small correction. It is like get the data from port B. So the correction is something like, please do the correction in your notes. Get the data from port B. This is B. This should be B and send it to port A. Okay. So now, first base address you have to take 300. I am taking 300 as a base address. This is given here, use the address range. That means port A, I will use address 300. Port A, I will use the address 300. Port B, I will use address 301. Port C, I will use the address 302. And control register, I will use the address 303. First you have to configure the control register, then only these ports are configured. So first here base address, here you write 8255 equate base address, then control register equate control register value 83h. Now move DX 300 plus 3, this value 303, I am moving 303 to DX. So now DX becomes 303. Now control value is moved to AL. What is control value? 83. Control value is 83 is moved to AL. What do you mean by the control value 83? 83 means what? 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 1. So you have to see the control register format. Let us see first control register format for this one. So we'll go back and see control register format for this one. 1 0 0 1 0 0, that means port C, lower port is configured as here you can see port C is configured, lower port C is configured as input port, and port B is configured as input port, and upper C is configured as output port, and port A is configured as output port, and last bit is input output mode. So these are the configurations. So let's move to the now to the program. So first the value 83, what I told you now, what is 83 is moved to control register, sorry, 83 is moved from 83 is moved from control to AL register, then from AL to output port. Port DX is 303 here. Port DX here is now right now 303, that is the port of the control register. So port of the control register. Once you complete this, all these ports are configured. So all these ports are configured. So please remember, if it is 8255, 303 is output port. So first you have to, this microprocessor is interface to 8255. First you have to move control value to AL. So here AL contains 83. Then you have to move AL content to this one. That time all these registers are, all these ports are configured. That means port A is configured as a output port, port B is configured as input port, port C is lower port C is configured as input port, upper C is configured as a output port. Once this is done, next get the data from port B, because port B is a input port. Get the port data, first move the address of the port B in DX, get the data from port B in AL comma DX, because DX contains 301. So sorry, 301, yeah, 301. From here, get data comes. From here, data comes, and that data is stored in a AL. Now move the data, get the data from port B and move the data from port A as out. For that you have to move the address of the port A first to DX, then AL out DX. Whatever is there in the AL is moved to DX. Then get the data from the lower port C and send it to the upper port. So now port C is configured in two mode. Lower port is configured in input mode, upper port is configured in output mode. So first you have to load the port C address. What is port C address? 302 here, 302. Then in data, in DX, AL. So the data comes through port C, lower port C and stored in AL. Then and this data, because we want only lower port bits. Then rotate left. Now this becomes whatever data, lower 4 bits becomes upper 4 bits. When you rotate left, whatever data, lower 4 bits becomes upper 4 bits. Then send it to output port, whatever content of AL, send it to output port DX. So this is the program.